Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Mariam Wasif Khan, and I am the convener of the Mushtaq Gurmani School's Committee on Academic Integrity. Academic integrity is a core value at LUMS, and we'd like that all of you know a little bit about what it means and how to maintain academic integrity when you start your LUMS career. So the first question or the first thing that might come to your mind is, what is academic integrity? Academic integrity means that you are truthful and honest in the way that you conduct yourself during your work, during your intellectual life at LUMS. Iska matlab ye hai ki jab aap koi bhi LUMS mein exam, koi essay, koi bhi assignment, koi coding assignment computer science mein for example kare, to aapka aapko puri tarah se aapne ensure karna hai ki ये काम आपका है और आपने किसी से ये काम बोरो नहीं किया हुआ. This means, for example, that your work is entirely your own. You have not asked a friend to write a paper for you. You have not copied it from somewhere else. And that is how you will maintain academic integrity, right? So it means that you are truthful to your instructor and your peers, your classmates, about the fact that any work that you submit is entirely your own effort. Some of you may be wondering, how do I maintain academic integrity at LUMS? Obviously, you might be thinking people make mistakes, or you don't know exactly what it is that you are supposed to do. So maintaining academic integrity means that any quiz, essay, exam, assignment that you complete should be done entirely by yourself and without the help of anyone else. This also means, for example, that you cannot ask somebody to tell you an answer in the exam room, for example, or you cannot ask a friend, yaar mera ek sentence likh do, ya isko edit kar do, ya mujhe apna paper dikha do, main thodi si ideas le lun tumhare paper se. So you can't do any of that when you are completing an assignment. Second, sometimes you might get confused. Professors might ask you to undertake certain presentations. So many courses, especially in the business school, but also in the humanities and social sciences, ask students to make presentations together. So a group of you might be working on stuff. Other times you might be asked to engage with the work of other scholars. Whenever you do this, you have to make it very clear what part of the essay or what part of the presentation is yours and what is somebody else's work. So for example, especially, and this is of course especially confusing when you write an essay. Aksar ye hota hai ki LUMS mein students aake kehte hain ki mujhe nahi pata tha ki Wikipedia se copy karna aur apne essay ke andar pura section dal dena ek it is a violation of academic integrity, right? Likewise, many of them will say ki maine to sirf apne friend se kaha tha ki wo ek do sentences mere theek kar de. These are all things that you will end up doing. You may also at other times, for example, a professor might ask you to read somebody else's work, another scholar or professor's work, and use it in your paper. Iska ye matlab nahi hai ki aap kisi ko bataye na ki us scholar ka kya kaam tha aur aap usko bas waise hi likhte hain paraphrase karke, okay? You must always acknowledge कि ये किसी और का काम है, और that acknowledgement usually takes place through the word, through the use of inverted commas. It takes place through what we call a citation system, which I will talk about in a later part of this video. At the same time, it also means कि जब आप एक when you're sitting for an exam, you cannot use a cell phone. ये नहीं हो सकता कि आप एक exam economics का दे रहे हो या psychology का, and you suddenly decide, okay, oh, let me WhatsApp my friend sitting next to me and ask them what the answer is, okay? These are all of these are examples of violations of academic integrity, okay? And what we want you to do is to maintain academic integrity, right? We want you to make sure that you are always very clear about what your part in an essay or an assignment is and what that of others is, okay? Sometimes, and this is in fact, this happens very often at university, our work becomes what we call collaborative, okay? Now, collaboration is very different from what we call plagiarism or academic dishonesty. Collaboration means that a number of people are working together. This could take the form, as I said earlier, of a presentation. It could also mean that you are engaging with the work of other scholars. So for example, aap Allama Iqbal ke upar ek essay likh rahe hain ya aap Hitler ke upar ek essay likh rahe hain, Hitler ke bare mein essay likh rahe hain. Shayad aap koi bahut bade scholars ho, aap for example unka kaam istemal karna chahe. Iska matlab hai jab aap ye karenge, aapne ye nahi karna ki aapne chup chap karke kitab se chhapa maar lena hai, unki kitab se ya unke article se chhapa maar lena hai. Aapne apne kaam mein likhna hai ki maine X, Y and Z professor, X, Y and Z scholar of Allama Iqbal or Hitler का काम पड़ा है और वो अब मैंने अपने एसे में इस तरीके से शामिल किया हुआ है. Something else professors will ask you to do, especially during essays, essay writing, और ये मुश्ताक गुरमानी स्कूल में बहुत ज़्यादा essays आपको लिखने होते हैं. Professors may ask you to cite sources. What does it mean to cite a source? One of the things you will learn very fast in your freshman writing and communication class is that there are citation styles. So aapko jald az jald pata chalega ki ek citation style MLA hota hai, ek citation style Chicago hota hai, ek APA hota hai, aur iska istemal kaise karna hai. Jab bhi aap essay likhenge, for example, agar aapne ek sentence kisi aur scholar ke kaam se liya ho aur aap us sentence ke bare mein थोड़ा सा हमें बताना चाहें या वो सेंटेंस आपके आपकी आर्ग्यूमेंट आपके मुकदमे को क्लैरिफाई कर रहा है तो आप हमें बताना चाहेंगे कि वो कहाँ किसने लिखा है कहाँ इस्तेमाल हुआ है. The way in which you cite this work, the way in which you will be able to acknowledge that scholar and there's a particular system of doing that, that system is known as a citation system. And I would advise you all to look up the MLA system because that is the first system you use. Is video ke saath saath aapko ek handout bhi milega which you can refer to in order to really get a detailed sense of what a citation style looks like. You know, some of you might be wondering what a plagiarized paper looks like. A plagiarized paper can take many forms, okay? Sometimes a plagiarized paper will be written by somebody else and the professor will have a sense that the student who has submitted it has not written the paper himself. Sometimes the professor will be able to see that you have actually borrowed bits and pieces of somebody else's words and you have not put inverted commas around them. Other times they will see that something is missing from your list of works cited or the bibliography that accompanies your paper. In either way, a plagiarized paper does not. And sometimes you may think that it looks pretty good and that, you know, nobody is going to find out that you've plagiarized. But rest assured, professors will know because they will be looking for certain markers within your paper, okay? Now, sometimes students make the mistake of not including inverted commas and just putting a piece of text. Don't do that. Whenever you cite from somebody else's work, whenever you quote somebody else's work, make sure that you have inverted commas around the sentence you have borrowed. अगर आपने किसी और स्कॉलर या किसी और प्रोफेसर का काम अपने एसे में डालना है, उस जहां भी आपने इस्तेमाल किया हुआ है, चाहे ये विकिपीडिया एंट्री ना हो, एक तो आई वुड एडवाइज यू नॉट टू यूज विकिपीडिया एंट्रीज, बट इफ यू डू, मेक श्योर दैट दैट पार्ट ऑफ योर एसे इज आइदर विद इन इनवर्टेड कॉमास और हाईलाइटेड इन सम फैशन टू शो दैट इट इज नॉट, दोज आर नॉट योर वर्ड्स. ठीक है, ये आपके अल्फाज नहीं है, ये किसी और के अल्फाज हैं जिनका आप इस्तेमाल फरमा रहे हैं. Finally, let me go over a few examples of what plagiarism can look like at LUMS. These are not exhaustive, but they pretty much are the most frequent cases that we see at the university. So first of all, somebody else wrote your paper for you, right? आपने किसी दोस्त से कहा, यार मेरा पेपर लिख दो, मेरे पास टाइम नहीं है, और उन्होंने कहा, हाँ ज़रूर मैं लिख दूंगा. दूसरा एग्जाम्पल ये है कि आपने अपने दोस्त का पेपर देख लिया, या आपने कोई इंटरनेट पर आपको एक पेपर मिल गया जो आपको लगता है कि आपकी असाइनमेंट से मिलता जुलता है, और आपने उस पेपर को वर्ड फॉर वर्ड नहीं मगर आपने उसकी आइडियाज़ वगैरह सब कॉपी करके लिखती हैं, और अक्सर इसमें आपने सेंटेंसेस वगैरह भी बोरो किए हुए हैं. तीसरा ये हो सकता है, और स्टूडेंट्स अक्सर हमें कहते हैं, मेरी अम्मी ने मुझे हेल्प किया, मेरे अब्बू ने मुझे हेल्प किया, मेरे भाई ने मुझे हेल्प किया. प्लीज़ डोंट टेक हेल्प ऑन योर पेपर्स, ओके? डोंट आस्क एनीबॉडी टू हेल्प यू राइट अ पेपर. समटाइम्स यू आस्क अ फ्रेंड टू एडिट योर पेपर. आपको लगता है कि आपका दोस्त जो है जब वो आके आपका पेपर पढ़ेगा और उसको ठीक करेगा तो आपका पेपर ऑब्वियसली बेहतर हो जाएगा. नॉट अ ग्रेट आइडिया, बिकॉज योर फ्रेंड माइट मेक मोर एडिट्स then are safe, and that of course change your paper entirely. So it is best not to ask a friend to edit your paper. Plagiarism or cheating, academic dishonesty, also means that you are sitting in an exam room and you look at somebody else's exam. It also means that you could be using a cell phone during an exam and texting a friend or looking up, of course, on the internet, the answers to the question that you are attempting. It could also mean you went to the bathroom and had notes on you somewhere that you were not allowed to use. If you are confused about whether you think you might be plagiarizing, please seek help. Go to a professor, go to your TA, or go to the academic writing lab. But do not continue if you are in doubt of your own integrity. If you are caught plagiarizing, so let me start off by saying that LUMS takes plagiarism very seriously. There are several committees in place that are known as academic integrity committees or disciplinary committees that will try your case if a professor complains about you being found or about even suspecting you of academic of being in violation of academic integrity. Okay, so that means you will have to sit in front of a tribunal of professors. कोई तीन चार अक्सर पांच faculty members आपको बिठाएंगे और आपका interview करेंगे, आपके paper को देखेंगे, उसको पढ़ेंगे, उसको check करेंगे, और अगर उनको ये लगे कि आपने cheating की है, you will be in great trouble. There are various penalties for cheating at LUMS. Okay, in the best case scenario, अगर आपने cheating की हो, आपने सोचा हो कि ओहो मेरा C नहीं, शायद B आ जाए, B नहीं, शायद A आ जाए, और ये पता चल जाए किसी को कि आपने चीटिंग करके ये ग्रेड बढ़वाने की कोशिश की है, यू विल गेट एन एफ एट द वेरी मिनिमम. एफ से ज़्यादा, एफ तो हम बहुत कम देते हैं जब हम किसी को चीटिंग करते हुए पकड़ते हैं. ज़्यादातर स्टूडेंट्स को हम एक सेमेस्टर के लिए घर भेज देते हैं, अक्सर वो एक साल भी बन जाता है. दिस मीन्स दैट योर ग्रेजुएशन इज हेल्ड अप एट लीस्ट अ ईयर. इवन इफ यू टेक अ सेमेस्टर ऑफ, चांसेस आर यू विल ग्रेजुएट एट लीस्ट अ ईयर लेटर देन योर क्लासमेट्स. यू नो, वी डू दिस वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली. ये मत समझें कि किसी को नहीं पता चलेगा आपने चीटिंग की है, हमेशा पता चल जाता है. सो प्लीज डोंट चीट योर ग्रेड. इट्स बेटर टू गेट अ बी देन टू गेट एन एफ. इट्स बेटर टू गेट अ सी देन टू बी आस्क्ड टू टेक द एंटायर एकेडमिक ईयर ऑफ. Finally, I mean, let me also offer some advice to help you, you know, not cheat. I know it's very tempting sometimes when you think that things are, you know, really not working out, and you think, okay, let me just ask my friend to fix one paragraph of my essay and it'll get better, or let me quickly ask somebody else to write my essay because I don't have time. Don't get yourself into a situation like that, okay? So first of all, develop steady work habits. This means that you work regularly, you go to class regularly. Take notes when you're in class. Don't sit and stare at the ceiling or the sky, or at least for this semester, at your laptop, or turn your laptop, or turn your Zoom, I don't know, mute your Zoom or whatever, but turn your screen off. Be present in class, okay? If you take notes, if you attend class regularly, chances are you will do well in the course, okay? In all of your essays, cite sources. Cite everything possible so that you are not in it. It's better to cite more than to cite less. Remember that, okay? Don't share your work with others. Don't even offer, even if a friend says, yaar mujhe apna essay dikha do, mujhe zara si main check kar lun ki mera sahi hai ya nahi. Don't do that, because that means you will be implicated in a cheating case that your friend is implicated in, okay? And both of you will be punished. So don't think that, oh, just because I'm the helper and someone else is the cheater, you know, that all will be well, okay? It won't. Don't use a cell phone, don't pass notes during an exam. And above all, remember, your integrity and your honesty are not worth a grade.